Hi, this is John Kubicek from Buddy TV, and I'm here on set of Supernatural with Jensen Ackles. Hi, Jensen.
How you doing?
Great. Now, you guys just recently started finishing this third season after the writer's strike. What was it like coming back, and what did you do with your unexpected vacation?
It was really nice to finally get the phone call. I think it lasted a little longer than I was anticipating. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't welcoming it at the beginning. You know, simply just give us a little bit more of a break over the holiday season. But that kind of turned into a bit of a lengthy stretch, and I got really nervous because I thought we were going to lose a lot of momentum. I thought we were going to lose some of our crew. Luckily, the phone call came. At a good time, we were able to get everybody back together. The writers had some scripts kind of lined up, ready to go, and we were able to kind of hit the floor running. So that was nice, and I'm glad that we're back. You know, we're shooting four more episodes to round off season three, and then we're going to launch into season four, which we've already got the pickup for, which is great. As far as the time off, I didn't do a whole lot. Kind of rested because I know that I wanted to catch up on my sleep, because those first 12 episodes are it's a pretty much a grind. So I spent some time with my family, my friends. Took an opportunity to do some publicity down in Australia. So I made a trip down there and met some of the people and the fans down there. That was great. It's a very well-received show down there, so I was happy to see that.
And probably the best thing about sort of finishing up this third season is that you have this story arc of Dean. How is he going to wrap up this deal that he made with sending his soul to hell? So how has Dean changed in these last four episodes? What is sort of like... what is his driving factor in resolving that issue?
Well, I think in the first 12, the first half of the season, he was really just kind of trying to make the most of his days on, that he had left. And by that, I mean, he was going out and playing poker and picking up women and doing everything that he thinks are, life's luxuries. But now that, the impending doomsday is coming closer and closer, I think he's starting to get a little nervous and a little scared. And I think he's trying to figure out if there's any way that he can get out of this deal. So there's a little bit more hesitancy in his part, there's a little bit more caution. Obviously, Sam is still kind of driven to find a way out, but he knows that there isn't one. And so it's that kind of reality is finally setting in, and it's grabbing hold of him pretty tight.
And is there going to be a resolution by the end of the season? Is it going to end with just Dean signing an extension of a 1 year longer on his contract? Or
I don't know. I had a brief conversation with Eric Kripke, the creator of the show, and he said, he always keeps people guessing. I tried to make predictions about where the story was going in the first season, and I learned quickly that they just don't even try. So I don't know. Maybe Dean buys an extension. Maybe Dean gets out of his deal somehow, maybe he goes to hell.
In anticipation of this set visit, we actually asked a lot of our fans on Buddy TV to submit some of their questions for you, and we chose sort of two that are our best. And the first one, Melanie from Buffalo, is just wondering, how much input do you have on sort of your character and the lines and even down to the wardrobe of your character?
Input on the character... Well, I would say that my input on the character is kind of done accidentally. Maybe little phrases or ad-libs that I add here and there during the show. If I utilize a certain prop, or if I, utilize a certain piece of clothing or something, the writers are in tune with that, and they'll watch that, and they'll see that, and they're like, I like that. Let's keep using that. Let's keep writing that in. So a lot of that is just, spontaneous stuff that I come up with, or the scene presents itself with, or just the character would make sense for the character to do, and then the writers are like, hey, perfect. As far as like premeditated things on my character and like, no, I don't think he would do this, or these guys have been writing them since day one, so they know him just as well as I do, and we've been on the same page ever since, and there's never been any kind of headbutting as far as what the character should be doing or where it should be going or why it should be doing what he's doing.
And then another question from someone who just have their screen name, and it's Jackals Obsessed, so you know they're a hardcore fan.
It's actually
fan.
My mother.
Or
Jared.
This user wants to know that last summer you actually did some stage work in A Few Good Men, and if you have any intention or plans to return to the stage.
No plans yet, and I'm not sure I have intention to either. It was something that that just kind of came about, and the opportunity presented itself, and I was like, you know what, yeah, I'm not doing anything, and there's nothing better. Like, I just enjoy challenging myself and trying to stretch myself, you know, as far as this craft goes, as much as I can, because that's I think, the best way to get better. So I saw it as a challenge, and I decided that, you know, why not? And I gave it a shot, and it was almost like overcoming a fear for me. And I did it, and, you know, it was kind of like one of those closing night. I was like, all right, I did that. I can mark that off the list. But, you know, whether or not something else comes up and really piques my interest, who knows, maybe.
And then just regarding, like, the fans and the internet, like, do you ever, like, sort of, like, read what the fans are saying on the internet, or is it just, like, the conventions? And what has sort of been your interaction with all of the devoted fans?
I honestly try not to. I mean, I have. I'd be lying if I said, and, you know, surf them every now and again. You know, but I actually try to make an attempt not to, because I don't want to be too influenced on how I play the character. And I know that if you read too much stuff and fans say, oh, I hate it when he does this, or I hate it when, it's going to make me conscious of that. I'd rather not know that I'm, you know, doing something that they really like, because then all of a sudden I'm doing it consciously as opposed to just doing it naturally. So for that reason, I try to stay away from the critics and from the, you know, the fan feedback and stuff like that. But I hear enough of it through my girlfriend or my mom anyway, so it doesn't really matter.
Okay.
And we have time for one last question. He's gotta go.
Okay. And then I guess my final question would just be, what is the most embarrassing story you can tell us about Jared?
That he has to wake up every day and look in the mirror, I guess, would be the most embarrassing thing. You know, I don't know. What was the most embarrassing? Well, there was a good one that was on. It was actually on the on the season 2 gag reel. Jared was he was trying to pump up for a scene he had, and he was putting on some weight, and we were in a graveyard scene, and we were supposed to be digging a grave, and he takes a shovel and makes a big downward swing with the shovel in the back of his pants, and the camera's actually on our backs, back his pants just. Whip ripped wide open, and if you see that outtake, you'll notice that I'm laughing hysterically, probably more than I should be after some. But it was funny because he was talking about, man, I'm like putting on this weight, I'm like retaining all this water, and I'm like such a girl, dude. And then he does that, and his pants rip, and I just couldn't hold it in. It was hilarious. What an idiot.